A lot of times in instructional sessions with young ladies at camps or clinics, we'll ask them a question about hitting. Do you like to hit? Is it fun to hit? The answer is typically yes. So we go a little bit farther. Is it fun to hit a dribbler back to the pitcher or a weak pop-up to the third baseman? The answer becomes different. It now becomes, no, that's not much fun. Well, then when is it fun to hit? It's fun to hit bottom line when you hit the ball hard. When you get solid contact with the ball and you drive it, that's when it's fun to hit. And we want hitters to have fun. So we're going to look at how to hit the ball hard consistently. That's when you're most successful. Now there's some ingredients that go into that. One is you've got to want to hit the ball hard. Some people go into the batter's box and are merely a batter rather than a hitter. They're standing in the batter's box, they've got a bat in their hand, so the rule book calls them a batter. We want hitters, people who want to hit the ball hard, who want to attack the ball, who want to drive the ball. You then got to believe that you can do that. Now, this tape will not deal much with the mental aspects of hitting. That's a different topic for a different time. But you've got to want to, and you've got to believe that you can. Then you've got to learn some techniques or mechanics that allow you as an individual to hit the ball hard. These may differ for different people, and we'll talk about that a lot and show you some ways that you can work at that today. We've also finally got to practice those techniques and those mechanics so the things that your brain knows, your body's able to do. It's not just a matter of knowing it. You've got to be able to do it. So you've got to want to, believe to, learn how to, and then practice so that you really can. Now, what are these techniques? That's what we're going to explore over the next hour or so as to what the techniques and mechanics are for this swing that allow you to hit the ball hard. But there are a lot of questions about what's right and what's wrong, what's best, what's better, whatever. And it kind of creates a tough situation for coaches and players. I call it Donald's Dilemma. It's named for a guy named Donald Self from Virginia who used to write me a lot of letters about hitting. And he was a student of the game. His daughter played softball and he coached a travel team. And he would go to a lot of clinics, he would watch a lot of videos, read a lot of books, ask a lot of questions. And when you do that, you get a lot of different answers. One person says put the elbow here, another one says put it there, somebody says step this way, somebody says step that way. And Donald wrote me some detailed letters asking these kind of questions. And bottom line, what he basically was asking is who's right? Is Ted Williams right or Charlie Lau right? Is Sue Enquist right or Mike Candrea right? Or Ralph Weekly or Ralph Raymond or whoever the guru is that you talked to that day, who's right? Well, it's basically not a question of right or wrong. So the question being asked is not the right question. There's more than one right. It's kind of similar to a mathematical situation. If you've got to get the number 100 and you've got to take two other numbers and get to 100, how can you do it? Well, one young lady may say, well, you add 50 and 50. Is she right? Of course she is. Somebody else might say you add 75 and 25. Is she right? Of course she is. Or 200 minus 100, or 1,000 divided by 10, or 50 times 2, or whatever you want to say. There are a lot of rights. What we're looking for in hitting is easier versus harder. Not necessarily right versus wrong. Jack Nicklaus, one of the best golfers that ever played, said that every golfer, when he swings a golf club, should have one purpose, and that's to impart correct impact of club and ball. And if he can consistently do that in whatever manner he uses, then we don't really care how he does it. That's kind of similar in hitting. If you can take the ball and the bat and them solidly meet consistently, then the manner in which you do that, your style, can be different than the manner in which somebody else does that. You've only got to be right, according to the scientists, for about 1/1,000th of a second. That's really not too much to ask of your players, is it? They've only got to be right for 1/1,000th of a second. Now, that can get pretty difficult. How do we do that? That's what we're going to look at. To put all of this stuff in perspective, you've got to have some kind of pattern, some kind of mold to put this in. Because we get bombarded with information. We've got to have something that this fits in, and we've got to ask ourselves, does this make sense? Let me give you a couple of ways to look at hitting. I like to call it a controlled explosion. You've got to have an explosion, you've got to have a force, you've got to have an attack, you've got to have impact, but it's got to be at a certain spot. So you've got to have an explosive swing at a certain place at a certain time. So I call it a controlled explosion. You need to basically control four things. You need to control the bat. That's the implement with which you're going to impart the force onto the ball. You've got to control the body because that's what creates all of this force. You've got to control the brain. That controls everything. That's basically your computer system. And you've got to control your eyes, which are really your radar. They locate the ball, the target that you're going to fire your missile bat at. And then you've got to explode. So you've got to control your bat, your body, your brain, and your eyes, and explode, a controlled explosion. It's a simple way to remember that, and kind of a kid's way to remember that. Bat, body, and brain start with the letter B. Eyes and explode start with the letter E. B and E, they're our letters of the day. And if you can remember Sesame Street, there are a couple of good friends, Bert and Ernie. Bert starts with B, Ernie starts with E. Bernie reminds your hitters to control their bat, body, and their brain. Ernie reminds your hitters to control their eyes and to explode. Now, second way to look at hitting in a more sophisticated way, if you want to think of it that way, is there's four stages. The first is called collecting visual information. Now, that's graduate school talk for studying the ball, and we'll deal with vision as we go into this video. But you've got to collect visual information, pitch data, if you want to call it that. When the pitcher throws the ball to the batter, the first thing you've got to do is see that ball very well and study it. The second thing you do is you analyze what you just saw. You figure out what it means. The third thing is you make a decision. You've got to decide what to do about all of this stuff. I see this ball, it's coming to a certain place at a certain time. What do I do? Do I swing or do I not swing? If you decide to swing, you make some more decisions. Where do I swing? When do I swing? How do I swing? And finally, the fourth part, and the one that we seem to spend the most time on, and this tape will deal with this substantially today, is the action, the swinging. So you collect visual information, you analyze that information, you make a decision about that information, and you act on that information. So a couple of ways to kind of put hitting into a mold, into a formula, a pattern, whatever you want to call it, is a controlled explosion, controlling the bat, body, brain, eyes, and then exploding. Or another way of looking at it is collect visual information, analyze that information, decide what to do about that information, and act upon that information. Those are the patterns that we'll follow as we go through this video today, learning to hit the ball hard.